Hi! In this video, you learn about the cycle we use when we make a mathematical model. In scientific papers, research is often presented as question, materials or methods, and then results and conclusions. So a research paper might seem to be a linear process from the question to the answer in one go. However, the path that has been followed to obtain those results is almost never linear. By definition, research is new, and most often the first results are not good enough, or the conclusion does not exactly answer the question you started with. So you have to go back and use a method that is better suited, or you might have to rephrase your question. Only after the project, when you know everything, you can present the result in this linear fashion. The process of mathematical modeling is better represented as a cycle. You start with a question, the problem. Then you construct a first set of equations that describe the phenomenon, the mathematical model. Then we solve the equations, and then we do some critical thinking. Are these solutions valid? Are they good enough to answer the question? Most often they are not, and we have to cycle a second time. You can improve the model, maybe change a parameter or add a new term. We might also have to improve the calculation method so that it gives more accurate results. And then we validate the results again. Are they good enough to answer the question? It might even be that the problem we started with has to be changed. It might be too general, and then the problem has to be specified more precisely. And so we go round and round until the problem is solved satisfactorily. Of course, you start with the simplest model that might do the trick. A simple model is easier to understand and more elegant. Only when necessary, you make the model more elaborate and include more details. Likewise, use the simplest, quickest calculation method first. You only have to move to a more sophisticated method when the results are not accurate enough to answer the question. One of the pitfalls of mathematical modeling is to lose sight of the whole cycle. You might build a model that is way too elaborate for the question, a model that includes too many details that are unimportant or even irrelevant for the problem. Or you might lose yourself in the calculations and achieve accuracy that is way too precise for the problem or for the relatively coarse model. So, always keep your eyes on the ball and follow the whole cycle. P for problem, M for medical model, C for calculations, and V for validation. In the next video, you see how the modeling cycle is used in this course.